Welcome to the snowiest state in all of the country. How can you prepare for winter this year? Well, that's what I'll be covering today, so stick around to see not only the more obvious things you need to do, but also things you might not have thought of. Hey, welcome to my channel, Living in Vermont. This is Jacob Barnes with eXp Realty. It's fall in Vermont, and while everyone is coming to visit the beautiful leaves now and enjoying the flannel season, in a few months, nobody will be visiting except skiers and snowboarders. If this is your first year in Vermont, or you are really just wondering how we survive winter, I'll be showing you that in this video. Also, if you're looking to buy or sell a home in Vermont, I got you covered. Just reach out. And as always, if you get any value from this video, make sure to like and subscribe. If you want to see daily Vermont content, go follow me on Instagram at Living in Vermont Real Estate. All right, let's get into it. First things first, let me describe Vermont winters to you. The average annual snowfall in Burlington, Vermont is 72 inches, but overall Vermont averages 86 inches per year. According to USA.com, the highest amount for a Vermont town annually is just under 150 inches in Cabot, and the highest for an American ski resort is 380 inches annually at Jay Peak. Well, it ranges all over the state, no matter where you live in Vermont, you'll have to deal with snow. It cuts off the gardening season from around September to May, it makes roads a lot more dangerous, and it might make you squint when the sun is reflecting off it. On the plus side, you won't have to mow your lawn for several months, so you get the variety between mowing and snow plowing that some other states don't have. In the winter, the temperatures average around 15 to 20 degrees Fahrenheit, and around 10 to 50 days per year are below 0 degrees. In some states, a snow day means one less day of school, but Vermont schools plan for several snow days in their annual calendar, so not much luck for kids unless it's an extra snowy year. Now, things you should definitely do to prepare for this. Number one, make sure your house heating system works before you need it. The average boiler lasts 10 to 15 years, and the average furnace lasts 15 to 20 years. If you are planning on buying a home in Vermont, make sure your real estate agent gets a furnace inspection and a cleaning ordered. Oftentimes, the seller will pay for it. General home inspections usually test the heating system, but furnace inspections are a lot more thorough. It's recommended you get it inspected and serviced annually, especially if it's older than 10 years. If you don't have a wood stove, you're probably going to need electricity to run your heating system, so it's smart to also have a generator in case your power goes out in the winter. If you have a wood-burning fireplace, you should have your chimney inspected and cleaned if needed each year, so you don't accidentally burn your house down. You'll also want several cords of wood stacked and easily accessible when you need it. If you need to replace your heating system or are looking to upgrade, probably the most efficient system used in Vermont is a heat pump. Number two, prepare your car for the winter. The best type of car for a Vermont winter is an all-wheel drive car. That's partly why Subarus are so popular in Vermont. If you don't have that though, you can still manage in the snow with good snow tires. I've always driven two-wheel drive cars, and except for a few steep hills I couldn't make it up, I've been just fine. Just so you know, all-season tires aren't going to cut it for a Vermont winter. Cheaping out on winter tires could cost you a lot. Studded winter tires are the best, but regular winter tires will work as well. If you get tires with rims, it's cheaper in the long run to have the tires swap from winter to summer, and with the rims, you can do it yourself. The general rules for driving when there's any snow or ice on the road include driving slower than you normally would, not following people as closely as normal, and going extra slow around curves. Try to avoid speeding up and braking quickly. Never stop on a hill if you can help it, and approach traffic lights slowly. You'll have to be extra aware of your surroundings in the winter. You'll also want to make sure your heater works before winter, but in case your car breaks down and your heater stops working, it's smart to keep blankets and an extra jacket in your car. It's also smart to keep sand in your car in case you do get stuck so you can give yourself some traction. On super cold days, you might have trouble starting your car, so you might want to get a portable jump starter. While several of the things I just mentioned aren't usually necessary, at least I can say I warned you. Number three, take care of yourself. Invest in good winter clothes. You'll definitely want a good jacket and some wool socks and winter boots. Take vitamin D supplements every day in the winter months. From November to April, the angle of the sun doesn't give Vermont enough UVB rays to produce vitamin D, so the Vermonters who don't take it are majorly deficient. Even if the sun was powerful enough, it wouldn't get through all the clothes we wear in winter. Vitamin D deficiency is linked with increased risk of cancer, sickness, fatigue, depression, and many other things, so you should definitely take it. Also, in winter, the temptation to stay home where it's warm is strong, but you need to make sure you get out and stay active. In the winter, it's popular to hike, snowshoe, ski, and snowboard. Of course, you can also go to the gym, but you might have to fight for a treadmill with more people running indoors than normal. Number four, everything else. Are you going to plow your driveway yourself, or are you going to hire someone else to do it? You will also need to shovel your steps, and you'll want to finish up by putting rock salt on your steps to get rid of any ice and prevent more from forming. If you don't have a heated garage, you'll want to start your car up about 5 minutes early so the engine has time to get warmed up and also so the heat starts going. If you do this in a garage, make sure you have the garage door open so you don't kill yourself with carbon monoxide. If your car was parked outside of a garage, you'll also need to brush the snow off your car and scrape any ice off the windshield as well. If you don't have a scraper and car brush, get one. You'll need it. Occasionally, we get freezing rain in the winter, and there are some sprays that supposedly make the ice melt faster, but the heat from your car will eventually help soften it up so you can scrape it off. Another thing about your car is that you'll need winter windshield wiper fluid, as regular windshield fluid freezes and could break the container. If you give yourself extra time to get the car warmed up and brushed off, and then drive slowly to work, you won't have to worry about being late for work or dropping the kids off at school. Alright guys, I think that pretty much covers everything. I hope you were taking notes. If you got any value from this video, please hit the thumbs up button. And if you are one of the 96% of people watching my video who haven't already subscribed, please make sure to do so. This is Jacob Barnes with eXp Realty, and I'll see you next time.